I'm just gonna do a loud noise so I can see the audio on each one.
You are maidenless.
You are maidenless. Hey, AJ.
No.
So, hey everybody, welcome back to another dirty shirt episode.
Yes, dirty clothes.
Because it's the end of the day, so we're a little soiled. But we're finally filming our end of the year video. And I know it's March, and we're 3 months late. But if you think about it, if you just found this channel, you know, and it's like the year 2025, you don't know the difference. But it's our end of the year video, so we're talking about all the fun stuff we did last year in 2023. And we did a lot of things, people. So we're not gonna talk about every single one because it's a YouTube video. It does need to be a documentary. Short, concise, to the point, entertaining, fun for both you and me and Carol. But in January of last year, I guess the most standout things that we did was we started the year with a senior photo shoot for one of Kara's students, Mickey.
Yay.
And she has the cutest little blonde curls on her head.
My goodness, yes.
But we did a photo shoot with her in January in Wisconsin. And she's like 100 pounds.
Yeah, she was a trooper.
It's like Elden Ring photography for her.
Oh, wow. Yeah, painful. And I felt bad because we get to wear more clothes.
So she froze that for 4 hours. It was a photo shoot and the photos turned out good. So it was fun for us. And now she's a big adult in the big metropolis of Milwaukee being a college student.
That's right.
So good job, Mickey.
Yay.
And another fun thing that happened in January was Kara's old school Auburndale came over for a field trip. It was fine for me because I never taught in Auburndale, but maybe it was weird for Kara.
I was nervous, for sure. Hopper coming over helped a ton.
Oh, that's right. We had special guests with Hopper.
Oh my gosh, that minute I saw her, I was just like, ah, okay, now this feels like it should.
So it was good for us to get back in front of students, teach a little bit.
Yeah.
It was fun for the students because they got to see how real artists in rural Wisconsin function and operate and that it is possible career choice.
It can be done in the middle of nowhere.
Other minor things we did in January was we finally started our Patreon page and we actually have patrons now. So thank you, patrons.
Yeah, thank you. That's fantastic.
Never thought that would be a thing, but it is. So it's still a struggle to make YouTube videos, content for social media, Patreon videos, but it's worth it. So then in February, we always do the Banbury Art Crawl.
The Banbury Art Crawl celebrates artists and small businesses from across the Chippewa Valley.
And that's in Eau Claire. And it's fun because it's a weird little warehouse that we're in and we get our own secret little cage that they display us in.
I'm just happy it's not yellow.
Yeah, it's not yellow. That one year it was yellow. Oh, that looks excessively orange.
I like that art venue because they actually listen to the artists, like they actually care.
But for every art fair, they usually send you a review. It's like, what could we do differently? And for Banbury in Eau Claire, they actually read what we wrote. Because we don't just write a little bit. Karen and I usually write a page and a half.
Well, that's our teacher brain kicking in.
We're thorough that way. In March, Kara started some pottery workshops.
And you're just trying to move here. That's okay. So then you're going to take and roll it off to the side.
So I don't know if that was nerve-wracking for you, but I felt great.
No. Actually, I felt pretty comfortable. I liked that I was able to continue teaching because I do miss it, but I like that I can do it my way and have control of the time, and it's just undivided attention. There's no distractions. It's not like I'm doing it in a public school, and it's not like I'm doing it in the middle of some big metropolis where people want to go shopping and out to eat and stuff. It's they come and they focus, and it's nice. It's an experience, and that's what I'm trying to do.
So we wanted to do workshops for a while, but we finally started in March of 2023 and Kara started it off with pottery because I think pottery is pretty safe. It's not like a table saw.
True.
Yeah.
True. True.
I think the coolest thing that happened in March was we actually got to see the Northern Lights for the first time ever. And not just a little bit, a lot of it.
That's right.
Kind of felt like a monster trying to get you.
Yeah, well, it looked like it was raining down. That was on the bucket list, and it's like, oh my gosh, it's in our backyard.
In April last year, we did a bunch of things like every month. I guess the biggest thing for me was the barn flooded.
fine. It happens to everybody.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
Everybody's woodshop.
Yep.
And it was one day where it was snow, and the next day it was liquid snow, and it all went right in the barn.
Liquid snow.
Liquid hot magma.
But on the bright side...
Magma. Sorry.
On the bright side, I have everything 4 inches up just because it's a barn, so nothing got damaged, but there's a lot of water, everybody.
In all my years living here, I've never, ever seen that.
Now I just have to find a new place to pee in the winter. I can't go out that door.
The world is your toilet. Mm-hmm. Every time you pee, you make a daisy.
I do. Another thing that happened in April was the Medford High School came over on a field trip.
Yeah.
And Medford is the town that Kara went to school in, so it's about 8 miles away?
Yeah, 8 to 10, yeah.
They came out just to see what artists do, because who knows real artists in this part of Wisconsin? They came over not knowing what to expect, and I think everybody had a fun time, including the teacher.
They were photography, right?
I believe so. But either way, art class came out, see us two cute little artists doing our thing. In May, that's when we start to get a little busy. We had our first big art fair, and this was down in Milwaukee. Inappropriate word of the day. Dangly parts. But we are absolutely not a fan of staying overnight or leaving the house or interacting with people or stuff like that, because, you know, antisocial.
Introverts around the world unite separately.
So instead of going down to Milwaukee Friday and then setting up Saturday, which is what we usually did, we decided to get up at 2 a.m. on Saturday, drive down to Milwaukee, and start setting up at 5 a.m. And it really wasn't too bad.
I think the hardest part is when you're at the fair and it's 2 in the afternoon, then you get a little groggy.
Yeah, then you get a little tired, but...
I'm really tired, everybody. Wanna go home?
Getting up at 2 a.m., driving down Milwaukee, piece of cake. You gotta try it sometime, everybody. So all the art fairs that we did in Milwaukee last year, that's how we did it. And chances are we do it again that way if we have the opportunity, because the less time we have to spend at an Airbnb or a hotel, the better we feel.
Mm-hmm.
So we just checked into our Airbnb. This is my pillow. This one's Kara's pillow, because she has a little tiny baby head. In May, Kara did one of her first painting seminars, and it was by Carmelo Blandino.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to loosen up, like I hear all of you saying, I want to get looser with my paints, I want to be able to express myself more, you have to stand up.
It was hard for her because she decided to do what he suggested and paint left-handed.
The whole seminar.
So, and Kara is more of a portrait painter, I would say. And Carmelo Blandino paints these huge epic flower paintings. So that's something that Kara wasn't 100% used to. She does paint flowers and stuff. Focus on the flowers and then do it left-handed. Her brain was a little mush.
A little.
And it was fun to watch.
Yeah.
I felt great.
I'm sure you did.
In June, it was kind of more of the same. We did another art fair down in Milwaukee. We really didn't make videos of them. I have all the video footage, but there's about 2 or 3 art fair videos that we have not made yet. Because like I said, people, we were busy. Few of them would only know all the footage we have that we didn't make videos on. It's a full-time job just doing videos.
That's true.
See, behind me on the computer, you probably can't see, but it's 77 folders with almost 2,000 video clips we took. So yeah, we have a lot of videos we haven't done with just what... A lot of work, everybody. A couple that we knew from a long time ago in karate, and then we also did wedding videography. They wanted some baby photos because they had a brand new bebe. So we went up there and took baby photos. And
way up north.
Yeah. And we've never did just like baby photos in somebody's house before, so.
That was fun.
It was fun because they inherited a lot of stuff in the house they moved into, so it was fun trying to do composition with clutter in certain rooms, and it turned out really well, at least I think so.
Mm-hmm. I would agree. They enjoyed them.
We tried to do some photos outside, but it was really hot and buggy, and when you got a brand new baby.
Yeah, like baby doesn't need a sunburn or mosquito bites.
Yeah, keep baby out of the bugs.
Yeah.
And I guess the coolest thing that happened in July was Kara has some paintings at a gallery that David Hummer owns, and he decided to put a bunch of the paintings that he represents at the Palm Supper Club in Weston, which is just right next to Wausau. And the weird part is, one of Kara's paintings sold at the Palm Supper Club.
Yeah.
And we chit-chatted with the owners, and it wasn't a regular or anything that bought it. It was just a person traveling through, stopped at a supper club, ate, saw Kara's painting, and bought it on the spot.
Yeah. And I'm like, I feel bad. It's like, I didn't even get to say goodbye.
What? No, you're not supposed to feel bad about selling a painting.
I know, but it's like, I would love to see where she lives now.
So that was super cool for us, because like a painting at a supper club sold. It's like, it can be done, everybody. It's the weirdest thing.
Unheard of. Well, I guess not unheard of.
It can happen to you.
It can happen to you.
And it can happen to you. I believe in it.
In July, I think that was our busiest month, because again, it's the middle of summer, art fairs, and we had art fairs down in Milwaukee again, except this time some of Kara's cousins showed up.
Mm-hmm.
So it was Dina and her partner Carol showed up.
Yeah.
And they're being supportive as always.
They are pretty rad.
They are.
You have to admit, their wit is so fast, you can't even keep up.
They're pretty quick at the sarcasm and being facetious. It gives me a run for my money.
And you know what? I just kick back and watch. It's like, mm-hmm. I could watch this all day.
Yeah, we both went to the Don Rickles School for Insults. For you young kids out there, you're going to have to Google who Don Rickles is.
Oh, yeah. It's like, they're going to have to Google it. They didn't even have time.
Just so you know, he's Mr. Potato Head in Toy Story.
That's right.
Look, I'm Picasso.
I don't get it.
You uncultured swine. What are you looking at, you hockey puck?
So thank you, cousins. We appreciate your support.
We love you guys.
The best part of any art fair is when we see our family and our friends.
Mm-hmm.
It helps that we make money at art fairs, but you guys showing up is the best part of those art fairs, no matter where those art fairs are.
Yes, agreed.
Mm-hmm. Also in July, Kara did some more pottery workshops.
That was not a rough month, just what if I'm tired already?
But what if I'm tired already?
I know.
Like, I'm just tired of being tired. I wants to be in a bad mood, and I wants to take a nap, not bust my every goddamn day.
It was a busy month for Kara.
It was busy.
Not so much for me.
You're just out in the wood shop.
I would come in, get some snacks,
yes,
leave. Also in July, we both got to meet my new niece-in-law, Bahar.
Yeah.
Driving Miss Daisy.
There's a hill here, so then you want to kind of baby him.
Who just had a birthday.
Yes, we just had a birthday, so happy belated birthday, Bahar.
Happy birthday.
And they are in the big province of Canada.
Yeah, I think British Columbia.
Yeah, way out on the west coast.
You are a little dyslexic.
I am a lot of dyslexic, everybody. Since we had success with Kara's paintings in the Palm Supper Club, we had an opportunity to put a bunch of Kara's paintings in a coffee shop in Green Bay. So we plumped up that space. I think she had about 15 paintings there on display for a month.
Yeah, give or take.
And it was fun for us because we've been to that coffee shop lots of times. We like coffee. We just didn't enjoy the hanging of the paintings because they had a special slat system that we just didn't work well with.
For how we have art paintings to hang on a wire, and for the size of some of them, it just wasn't a good system for that type of work.
The last thing we did in July was we had a wedding to do, and it was the Tracy and Mike wedding.
Yeah.
And it was a little scary for us because we did not know Tracy or Mike. Like a lot of the weddings we do, we know the people, but for some reason we didn't know these people. I think they got us through somebody we knew.
They did, and she also went to school in Auburndale, but I had her sister more than I had her as a student.
So again, shooting a wedding, high stress and lots of fun. So thanks for letting us be your photographers.
And it was fun out in the middle of nowhere.
Oh, that's right.
Mm-hmm, in the woods, but I like the woods shoot.
I forgot about that. We drove out to the wedding site, mm-hmm. and it was in...
It's a field.
It's a farm field.
Next to, it was bordering the woods.
We're not sure if we're at the right place because a farm field looks just like the next farm field. So that was a fun wedding to do. We never had that experience before, and now we do. So cool. Yep. Thanks, Tracy and Mike.
Yep, I like the very non-traditional avant-garde weddings.
Yes, yeah. That's a good way to put it.
Yeah.
August was another busy month, and I think the most memorable part of August was that's the month I had my colonoscopy.
Here we go.
And if you never had a colonoscopy, people, you need to try it. It's the best nap of your life.
It feels like you do half a yawn just...
the best baked potato of your life.
Oh my God. I had to fast for 24 hours prior to the actual procedure. But you fast for more than 24 hours by the time the procedure starts and ends. So when it was all done, I went 32 hours without food.
And this is coming from the guy that has to eat every 4 hours.
Then we got home, I made a baked potato, and it was the best thing I ever ate in my life.
And then you promptly passed out.
I passed the crap out. But good bill of health. Doctor said he'll see me in 10 years.
Yep,
so good job, colon. You're pop free. Another thing that happened that month is we did
you
another...
You love telling your butt story.
Make fun of my butt. Also in August, we did a wedding, and it was Jasmine and Devin, and it turned out to be the hottest wedding we ever did in our adult lives. Usually when we do weddings in July or August, it gets hot. It's about 90 some degrees out, but when the sun sets, it cools off. It didn't cool off this time. I felt bad for the DJ. He's playing for nobody because the dance floor is empty because nobody could, it's too hot. We left at about 10:30 p.m. and it was still upper 80s.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We were so sticky. The photos turned out so great, and
oh
she was
gosh.
The happiest, most cheerful bride we've ever seen.
I will say probably one of my favorite photos is the bubble one.
Oh, that was a good one.
That was just right place, right time.
So thanks, Jasmine and Devin, for letting us do your wedding.
Yes, that
was...
It was
a great, sticky wedding for us.
But it was fun.
Oh, man. When you hug people goodbye, you let go. You don't really let go.
You don't really let go.
Like a wacky wall crawler.
Yes. Bringing it back.
Also this month, Kara did a painting seminar by a guy called Wang Chung. Not Wang Chung. Victor Wang.
Yes. He's a fountain of, oh my God, his epic. Does he have the most, like, iconic epic work? Not just for technicality, but on the sheer scale of it.
Mm-hmm.
Insane.
So that was a fun painting workshop. Again, Kara's brain was mush.
Oh my God, it's gonna make me one heck of a Frankenstein, I'll tell you that.
The next month, September, that was a big month for me, I think, woodworking-wise, because I got my kitchen island done, I got my big table done, and I got my new favorite table done. It's the one with the gear in it. So I think I'm finally progressing to a point where I'm starting to like what I build. Also in September, one of our friends and patrons we know, we got to photograph her kid, Lydia, and she was also one that did Kara's pottery workshop earlier in the summer.
Well, her and her mom and her grandma did.
And all those people.
Yeah.
And it was fun to do a little model shoot with Lydia, and all the photos turned out so good.
Oh
and we were just flabbergasted that this girl knew how to pose. We took photos of her in disguise, ultimately, because we needed some photos of a donkey horse mule named Lloyd.
Wow!
I don't know the classification.
Davina's gonna be like, this guy doesn't know anything.
I don't know anything, everybody. But Kara was going to do a painting commission of Lloyd the donkey horse mule.
That's what we're going
to
call him.
So we had to sneak some photos in, but we used Lydia as...
As the bait.
As the bait. Davina's mom wouldn't find out about it.
Yeah.
But everything turned out good, so...
Yeah.
Thanks for letting us do it.
Yes, thank you for having us have a future model for painting too. Because that's awesome.
Also that month, we do an art fair every year when they accept us in Wausau, and it's the closest one to us. And again, all our family and cousins showed up. So thanks for showing up, all you cousins and family and friends. There's a lot of people that showed up.
Yeah.
We did a lot of talking.
Oh, my face hurt.
We did so much talking, we felt bad for the booths next to us because the group in back of the tent was getting a bit big.
Yeah, it's like, we gotta see if we can request a different spot for next year because you just take up way more room than you should.
So everybody that showed up that day.
Yeah.
So thanks for showing up, everybody.
Yes, thank you. And for all the support, again, we appreciate it.
Supportive family.
Yep, they are. I'm spoiled.
Also that month, Kara did another painting workshop by a Canada guy called Aaron Sidorenko. And he is quite the character. So if you don't know who Aaron Sidorenko is, he's up in Canada. He's a painter and a teacher. The only thing that can dwarf his paintings is his sense of humor.
Oh my God. That was so great.
He should really be a stand-up comic because when he would lecture, he would just throw in these weird things that just came to his mind. Everybody just stopped, looked, started laughing, and it was a very cool environment where you're usually stressed out as a painter trying to learn something from a guest painter. But he made it so comfortable and easy that Kara came up with two really good paintings.
I would say out of all the workshops I've been lucky enough to partake in so far, he was the one that I felt the most comfortable. And I don't know if it's because I'd be painting, he found out I was Irish, he'd come over, start lecturing me in an Irish accent, and I just couldn't stop laughing, or goofy little things like that, but just, like you said, the vibe he was giving off was just comfortable, but you were still learning, and I like that.
You like it, I do it again.
Like it, I do it again.
Also this month, we got a new rescue cat in Scully.
Tonight, you.
And she was a rescue cat because she was like 1.2 pounds when we got her.
1.46.
1.46. We were doing really good progress on her, but then about 7 months later, we found out she had chronic kidney failure, and there's nothing you can do about that, we found out. So we had our rescue cat, Scully, for about 7 months, and then we lost her. But it was a good 7 months because you always feel responsible when you can't save a life. But at the same time, if it wasn't for us taking her in, I don't think she would have had those 7 months. Now October. October is when it starts to slow down. We did two art fairs in October, and I would have to say they were not fun art fairs for us. I'm not gonna complain about them. I'll just show you some clips of how we felt about them.
Is one gonna be the wind?
Facility. I don't want to be tracking nuts in the van.
If it's
only nuts I want to see. Anna. So those were the two art fairs, and we shall not talk about those anymore.
What if I'm tired?
Oh my God.
Never once have I regretted my decisions so much. Like, you want to talk about challenging your ideas? Like, really thought you made a humongous mistake.
And now we're not going to talk about them anymore.
Oh, well.
The art fairs we shall not talk about anymore. We're gonna talk about it a little bit. The one we had in Stillwater, the only shining grace we had at it was, again, Kara's supportive family. So Cousin Teresa showed up and was supportive, and it's always nice to chit-chat with her.
Thank you, Cousin.
Thank you, Teresa. Besides the art fairs, we got to do an engagement photo shoot with Alex and Teresa. Last we saw Alex, he was probably in middle school in martial arts, and now he's a full-blown adult type person.
That's so weird to not see him.
He looks the same. He hasn't aged. In November, it starts to, you know, actually slow down to the part where we can do some farm chores and house chores and everything we neglect throughout the whole year. So we decided to do a small project in Kara's equipment shed, which is about 100 years old. There's two great big sliding doors on it that were about 10 feet tall by each 8 feet long. So the door opening itself was about 16 feet long. We decided to rip those out and install a garage door. But the thing is, the shed wasn't built for a garage door. Look, got a good 3/4 of clearance in there.
Is that all you need?
It works, I guess it is. So it was just an engineering feat to try and figure out how to install a garage door that was tall enough for the opening where the tractors can still fit out and...
Fit out?
Yeah, go out.
Just sound fit out.
Yeah, they gotta go outside. Tractor, go outside.
Fit out.
Tractor, go outside, had to go through door.
Outside, do work, go back inside, take rest.
And so that was an on and off project for about 2 or 3 months.
That was your forever project.
It was. It still is because it's not 100% done. I have the footage somewhere. I can't currently find it.
I keep it in a jar above my fridge.
I like it. I use it. I have a little. I keep it in a jar on top of my refrigerator. I'd like to put more in that jar. That's where you come in.
So if you see it in this video, I found it. If you didn't see it, I haven't found it.
Yet.
You gotta use your imagination station on that one then.
I know it's out there. We took so much.
I know we did. I just can't find where I put it.
It's there. There's so much footage. Again, that's why it's a full-time job.
Also that month, we got invited to do an art fair in Eau Claire. And it was an indoor art fair, and it was called the Clearwater Jazz and Art Festival. We didn't know anything about it, and we decided to try it out because what else are we doing in November? So we decided to try it out, and it actually was quite a good success for us.
Yeah.
Oh, Claire seems to like us.
Is it? It's a one-day thing, right? Yeah. No.
We did it. We had fun. So thanks for inviting us. Hopefully see you again this year.
Oh, they want us to do their August one, and I'm like, we must have made a good impression.
See you this year.
Yay.
We ended the year in December, like most people do. Kara got to meet up with her long-lost cousin, Kitten.
Yes. It's been a long time coming.
Mm-hmm. I've been in Kara's family for 23 years now, and I think I've talked to cousin Kitten maybe, I said 10 words. And it was nice to actually just sit down, chit-chat with her, and I think we visited for about 2-3 hours.
At least.
And it was just such a nice thing to actually get to know a person you actually know, but don't really know.
It was nice to reconnect and just listen to her.
And of course, another supportive family member.
Yes.
So thank you, cousin, we appreciate it. And the last thing Kara did in December was she had a due date on a painting commission for the horse mule donkey, Lloyd. Because it was supposed to be a Christmas present. I'm finding out, and I think Kara might agree with this, is she does really well under pressure with a due date.
Yeah, it's great.
It's good for me.
Yeah, if you weren't here, I'd die of starvation and forgetting to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, because I can read the clock.
There is no clock up here.
There are no bathrooms.
No more complaining, no more Mr. Kimble have to go to the bathroom, nothing. There is no bathroom.
There is no bathroom.
So that was our year in a nutshell. We did a lot of other things, and if we feel like we're going to talk about them, we might, and then we just might put them on our Patreon site, because our patrons get bonus content. So for all you patrons out there, thanks for supporting us. We really appreciate it. And also thanks to our newest patron. Who's that, Kara?
Hopper.
When you bring it down, it's just, and you get like really gravelly with it, that's where you get the Schmeagle voice. You get,
Yeah, the patron of Hopper.
The patron of Hopper. Mm-hmm. Sounds very regal.
Thanks for watching this video, everybody, and we will see you next time. Hopefully on time. But if not, just wait longer. Bye.
Bye.